Hello again, everyone, and welcome to the Infowars Nightly News. I'm your host, Darren McBreen. It is Thursday, May 17th, and here's a quick look at what we have lined up for you this evening.
Tonight on the Infowars Nightly News, documents surface exposing Obama's Kenyan birthplace. Plus, a federal judge issues an injunction against the controversial NDAA legislation. Then, Darren McBreen speaks with Kurt Linderman about the plight of labeling GMOs in the United States. All that and more tonight on the Infowars Nightly News.
All that and more coming up during the next 30 minutes or so. But first, breaking news on the Obama birth certificate scandal as new smoking gun evidence makes certain that so-called birthers, that's me, aren't going anywhere. Alex Jones reports.
Huge breaking news. We have a publication that Barack Obama put out where he was bragging that he was born in Kenya. We have his wife on video twice saying it. I wasn't a birther 4.5 years ago. It was the Hillary Clinton campaign that first put that out because they had a dossier on him, and the Clintons are famous for having all the old files from when Clinton was president. They still basically run much of Washington. But Hillary was bringing that out, I later learned, because it was true. Now, when she was defeated by him, she joined with him. But there's been big breaking news, ladies and gentlemen. It's on drudgereport.com right now. It's on Breitbart. Barack Obama, the first African-American president of the Harvard Law Review, was born in Kenya and raised in Indonesia and Hawaii. That's actually what the research shows. And what is this from? It is from a book promotion put out by his literary agent that Barack Obama approved of. The vetting exclusive Obama's literary agent 91 booklet, born in Kenya, raised in Indonesia and Hawaii. He had the name Barry Sataro and all these other names. They've sealed all his records. His friends said that he was from Kenya. I mean, his wife said it over and over again. And here it all is. Here's the full breakdown by the publisher of all their people. And there it is, Barack Obama. This is the reality. Now, let me show you this next video that I've got right here. This is Michelle Obama saying that he went back to his homeland, Kenya, to fight AIDS. Here it is.
Surrounding HIV testing, which is still plaguing so many of our communities, which you all know, a lot of that is due to homophobia. Barack has led by example. When we took our trip to Africa and visited his home country in Kenya, we took a public HIV test. For the very point of showing folks in Kenya that there is nothing to be embarrassed about in getting tested. And we did it as a couple.
Wow. Wow is all I can say right now. Listen, my listeners demanded I look into this. And first they said that the old birth certificate was the birth certificate when it was a receipt and printed off a computer. Then they put out that bad fake, which was fake. I want to put this to bed. Obama's funded by Goldman Sachs and the globalists. Obama is launching wars for congressional approval. Obama is launching drones in the skies of America. I want to go after him on the issues. But the point is, it's true. He's not who they say he is. It turns out the book about him that they put out is basically all fiction and has been proven to be a lie. The truth is, we don't know who this guy is. But his own literary agent said, born in Kenya, lived in Indonesia and then Hawaii, and that's exactly what the records and evidence shows. And the point is, he can be blackmailed with this information. That's why he's so controlled by the Chicago mob and the banksters and Corzine, who can steal billions from MF Global. This is huge news. And the Breitbart people that broke this, digging into Obama, they're like, no, Breitbart didn't believe this, but we've got to look at it. This is incredible. This isn't some typo where they say, you know, some word is wrong or get his mom's name wrong or something. This was put out, vetted publicly, and that's why all his other records are sealed. He's got all these other names. It's incredible. Look into it, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be covering it tonight on the Nightly News. 7 o'clock. We're trying to get Dr. Corsi on about this. And, of course, on the radio tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central, Infowars.com. Get this out everywhere. Added to the pile of evidence, this is the smoking gun. His own literary agent, born in Kenya. His grandma, born in Kenya. Dr. Corsi goes over there to cover it and to investigate, gets arrested. The Bush, we now learn, during the election, sent a letter, and the Kenyan government came back and said the records of his birth have been stolen. That document's public. Well, it means he was born there if the records were cut out of the files. Ladies and gentlemen, Barack Obama is a total, absolute cutout. He is a Manchurian candidate. Alex Jones signing off for Infowars.com. We have the Breitbart stuff posted at Infowars.com. So please get it out to everybody.
And thank you, Alex Jones. Now, you can find that report on our website. It's called Bombshell, Obama Born in Kenya. That's just more convincing evidence that the public has been sold one big, huge lie. Let's move on to our next headline. We've got good news in the fight against the National Defense Authorization Act, as a federal judge issued an injunction against a provision that grants the military the right to detain American citizens and ship them off to prison camps indefinitely. The NDAA says the military can secretly arrest you. Obama says, well, they can actually kill you. But a group of writers and activists, which include columnist Chris Hedges, Pentagon whistleblower Daniel Ellsberg, and others, have sued Barack Obama and Defense Secretary Leon Panetta. And the, well, there's a U.S. district judge. She has ruled in their favor. Basically, the judge blocked enforcement of part of the NDAA that allows indefinite military detention for, well, for activities like news reporting and political activism. I just happen to be doing both of those right now. So definitely an important and significant victory in the fight against tyranny on that front. Let's move on to Greece. An update on the economic collapse in Greece as we're watching the Greek system basically die right before our very eyes. Money is being pulled out at an alarming rate. You know, it's something drastic is doesn't happen soon. These banks are going to start dropping like flies. You know, there's the riots have already begun. We're looking here at an amateur video that shows violent protest in central Volos, where one of the largest banks, the Eurobank, was torched. Now there are rumors that the Greek government is considering placing limits on bank withdrawals. So most of the people in Greece, I think they get the feeling that they are dancing on the Titanic and they are pulling their money out as fast as they can. And who could blame them? Perhaps sign of things to come. You know, this is a true sign that, you know, this could definitely spread through Europe. The United States could eventually be next. The world economic crisis is definitely accelerating. And I encourage all of you to start, you know, invest in gold, buy silver, get stockpiles of food because it's on the way. It's time for you to protect your family. Be prepared. All right, let's move right along because there is a victory in the fight against water fluoridation. This out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, as water authorities in Albuquerque have decided to cut the fluoride from the city's water supply. And, you know, when I first heard about this, I was very excited, but I have to admit that my excitement was kind of deflated when I went to the website and I took a look at the local news team there in Albuquerque and their report. Well, I can barely stand to look at this again, but let's take a look.
The water authority official I spoke with says the level of naturally occurring fluoride in our city's water already meets the most recent recommendation.
We're going to err on the side of caution.
David Morris with the city's water authority says under the current standards, they don't need to add fluoride to Albuquerque's water.
All right, so there you go. That's the beginning. At first, they're talking to somebody from the water authority, and then next, they're going to talk to a dentist who's going to push the water fluoridation lie. But then we're going to take you to a video that we shot a couple years ago because I want to show you how real journalists are supposed to act. So Channel 4 in Albuquerque, pay attention because Dr. Conant will be on it. Let's take a look.
Virtually indisputable that fluoride drastically reduces the incidence of tooth decay in the general population.
I think the most important thing to recognize about fluoride is that it's extremely toxic. It is very active biologically, interfering with many basic biochemical processes, enzymes, G proteins, hydrogen bonds, and so on. So it shouldn't surprise us that there's a wide range of health effects that are attributed to fluoride. But the bottom line is that fluoride is extremely active biologically, that the first opponents of fluoridation going back to the 1950s were biochemists, including scientists like James Sumner, who won a Nobel Prize for enzyme chemistry. And incidentally, there is no doubt that fluoride damages health, because millions of people in India, China, and parts of Africa have had their health ruined by fluoride. The people have been crippled by fluoride and many other health effects.
So there you go. Dr. Conant was showing us a more realistic look at what fluoride really does to your body. But as we take a look, I want to look again at the Channel 4 news there in Albuquerque, because I thought we'd present this with some laugh tracks, because I think this is truly tabloid journalism at its worst. But I think it would be more properly presented if we were to do it like this.
Supplemental water fluoridation is the single most cost-effective public health measure to reduce dental disease. But it's something you won't be getting anymore when you take that sip of water from your tap.
It's fluoride. You need that stuff for your teeth, enamel, and all the stuff for your teeth that fights cavities.
Yeah, why would they want to take it away if it's something good for us?
No, I think there's a very good chance that by doing this, it will lead to increased incidence of tooth decay.
So there you have it, more properly presented that way, I think. That was Channel 4 on our side. We investigate, it should be more like we regurgitate the junk science of water fluoridation. There are no benefits of water fluoridation, okay? Let's get that straight. It is a chemical hazard. It is a byproduct of the aluminum industry and the fertilizer industry. All right, we're gonna move on. And I wanna cover this story out of Los Angeles, where LA County health enforcers are conducting door-to-door raw milk confiscations. This is California Food Police gone wild. This is an article by Mike Adams of Natural News, and a bombshell revelation of the depth of the police state that now exists in LA County. The health department has unleashed door-to-door raw milk confiscation teams that threaten to intimidate raw dairy customers into surrendering raw milk products that they legally purchase and own. Unbelievable. LA County and San Diego County have attempted to acquire customer names and addresses from organic pastures for the sole purpose of sending food confiscation teams to customers' homes to remove the raw milk from customers' refrigerators. So, I mean, this is incredible. Imagine the police going in, guns drawn, SWAT-style raids to family farms, and now door-to-door to remove the milk from your refrigerators. Simply unbelievable. Where does it all end? But not only is the government protecting us from making our own decisions on what kind of milk we want to buy, now they are also putting drones in the sky to protect us from the evil terrorists. This is news out of Denver, Colorado, where right now the FAA is investigating what they call an extremely dangerous incident, as one of these drones almost caused a mid-air collision with a jet over Denver. The mysterious object, thought to be a military or law enforcement drone flying in controlled airspace over Denver, almost caused a catastrophic mid-air crash with a commercial jet. The craft was reported as being about 2,800 feet above the ground at the time the pilot reported seeing it. It did not show up on radar. And Congress has recently passed legislation that will put about, 30,000 drones up over U.S. airspace by the year 2020. So I'm sure we could see, you know, there's probably going to be more catastrophes in the future. Meanwhile, in Dallas, a training missile drops from a helicopter and 100 homes are evacuated. About 100 homes in a Central Texas neighborhood had to be evacuated when a 6-foot inactive training missile accidentally fell from a military helicopter. What are they doing with military helicopters, missiles in military helicopters over Dallas? I have no idea what's going on. Federal government is here to help and keep us safe, I guess. Let's move on to our quote of the day. This one by Joseph Crowley, U.S. Representative for New York's 7th Congressional District. Some of the FDA's own scientists have charged that politics, not science, is behind the FDA's actions. Well, no kidding. All right, that just about wraps up the first half of our show. And before I go, don't forget, 15-day free trial membership, Prison Planet TV. Check it out. When we come back, I will be joined via video Skype live with Kurt Linderman Sr. Now, he's an investigative journalist. He's a contributor to the Infowars Nightly News, Infowars.com. And he's also a vaccine researcher. Kurt Linderman, when we come back.
I really enjoy it when the globalists try to poison us, and well, we resist them via a free market system. Hello, my fellow info warriors. Alex Jones here, introducing you to the ProPure family of gravity-fed filters. Now, you know that the globalists are filling our water with radioactive isotopes, fluoride, lead, mercury, arsenic. And one of the few systems that can efficiently and economically remove or reduce down to non-detectable levels these poisons are gravity-fed filters. And ProPure is the top of the line. Their filters are impregnated with silver, a natural antibiotic. On top of that, they're bigger, so they filter faster. You don't have to prime these the first time you use them. It's amazing. Go to Infowars.com and click on the shopping cart link to see the entire family of these babies. Now, the fluoride they add to our water is so tiny that most filters can't cut it out. But ProPure has their system that will, again, reduce it to non-detectable levels, almost get all of it out of there. That's also available. And if you look at the different systems they offer, the ProPure Big Brush Finish is on a stand, so it's easier on a table or at your restaurant or wherever you have it to go up with a glass or a mug and fill it up. Then there's this big baby right here, the ProPure King Large Version. Got a lot of different options that come with it. Also, they have the ProPure Big, probably one of the best values out there. And of course, it's burnished stainless steel. And then what I use on my RV, something that's great for your hunting cabin or the back porch, is the ProPure Traveler. Small and portable, but packs a huge punch, cleans out all that garbage. They also have a glass sight spigot, so you don't have to take the top off and look in the bottom area to see how much water. You can see how fast it's filtering with this optional system. The globalists obviously are hitting us through our water. It's time to take control of our lives. It's time to not give our children and families these poisons. And these systems cut it down to non-detectable levels across the board. ProPure is the name. I only promote what I believe in. And I use ProPure in my home and my office. And I recommend that you check out the information on ProPure at Infowars.com. We already have the lowest price at Infowars.com on the ProPure gravity filter system. But when you add in the 10% off when InfoWarriors use the product code WATER at Infowars.com, nobody can top it. So again, it's a win-win-win. Stop drinking the poison water. Checkmate the globalists when it comes to your health, and support Infowars.com and the work we're doing here. You know, many revolutionaries rob banks and things and kidnap people for funds. We promote in the free market the products we use that are about preparedness. That's how we fund this revolution against the New World Order in our move to restore our constitutional republic and a spirit of 1776 worldwide. Check it out at Infowars.com. ProPure, top of the line, number one, most powerful and effective and economical gravity-fed water system in the world. ProPure, available, discounted at Infowars.com. Don't forget product code WATER to save 10%. It's the latest generation, years in development. ProPure is the name.
And we are back. Thank you for joining us. This is the InfoWars Nightly News. I'm your host, Darren McBreen. And joining us now, live via video Skype, is investigative journalist, InfoWars contributing editor, and vaccine researcher, Kurt Linderman Sr. And he is also the host of Linderman Unleashed on the Natural News Radio. And Kurt is here to talk to us today about some important developments that are going on in the state of Connecticut, where House Bill 5117 was introduced to combat genetically engineered foods. It had a tremendous backing and support by the people of Connecticut. It looked like it was going to be a slam dunk until it got in the hands of Governor Daniel Malloy and his attorneys, who removed key sections of the bill due to fears of legal action taken by the biotech industry. Kurt Linderman Sr. joins us now to break this down. Hey, Kurt, it's good to have you on the show. What do you think about this bill? How close was it to seeing the light of day?
Well, Darren, thanks for having me. I'll tell you what, it was really close. And I think that's what got Monsanto and the other biotech corporations out there really nervous. It was so close because 85% of the Connecticut legislature was in favor of this bill. 90% of the public, which is what we see all across the country, 90%+ of the American people want to know, even if they're not against GMOs in their food, they would like to see it labeled. It's a no-brainer. They knew it was going to happen, so Monsanto had to do something about it.
Well, and this would require labeling of GMO ingredients, am I right?
Well, yeah, the bill had a number of different parts to it, but Section 2, which was essentially the only part that was removed by Governor Malloy, was the part that talked about labeling GMO foods. Now, that would have been devastating just because no food company is going to just label foods for one state. So that would have made them relabel all the foods across the country, essentially. So this was going to be a big deal. So that was the only part that was removed. It was the part about labeling of GMOs.
So sure, it would have been a domino effect. And what I take what probably happened, it was close to being passed. But then the governor behind closed door sessions, him and his attorneys, along with probably maybe attorneys from Monsanto, basically they got bullied by the biotech industry. They wussed out and the bill's going nowhere.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, and I'm not afraid to say this one bit. One of two things happened. Either the governor's a coward and just kowtowed, or he's a lot richer right now. Because I think he might have gotten paid off. That's a very distinct possibility. That's my opinion, though.
Well, this gives, you know, people the right to choose what ingredients they want in their foods. Obviously, if they see GMO ingredients, they have a right to decide, you know, what they want in their food. I'm surprised that this was blocked. But tell me, who was behind the bill? How did this get started? What are the origins of this thing?
Well, I'll tell you what, it was all started by Connecticut Right to Know and all of our good friends. The Institute for Responsible Technology, Jeffrey Smith, is really behind all of this. And it's going to, in a number of states, they're trying to do this. They're trying to do it in California right now, labeling bills, a bill to label GMO foods. And we really thought in Connecticut, and I'm not a resident of Connecticut, but I did some interviews with some of the key players there, and it really looked like it was a no-brainer. It was going to happen until these shenanigans behind closed doors happened. And that was what the real spit in the face was it wasn't done, you know, the way the American citizens expect it to be done by vote, yay or nay. It was done all behind closed door, and they basically just took out the part that they really didn't want to see on the bill. And then they can act like, hey, we didn't do anything to the bill but take out a little section. But it definitely took out the entire intention of the bill.
Yeah, that was the meat and potatoes of the whole thing. And I understand that they had plenty of signatures. They were feeling pretty good about themselves. They were feeling pretty good about their chances, and they had faith in the system, but then they got slammed by a rogue governor of Connecticut and the biotech industry. What's next? What's their next move? How are they going to try to combat this from here?
Well, they're going to try to reintroduce the bill, is my feeling. I'm waiting for the session to end before I can talk to some of the real key players within the politics end of it, the sponsors of the bill and what have you. They're trying not to cause a big stir until after the session is over. And I do believe fully that they're going to try to reintroduce this bill. And the one thing in particular that I feel is going to happen is there's a number of citizens out there that are really angry. And they might just have a new governor by the time that the bill is reintroduced, because that SOB needs to get out.
Well, let's hope so. And, I was checking out your article that you posted on Infowars.com recently about this. It says in the article that this illustrates once again that big agriculture has total control over local, state, and federal governments, and that the weak and morally twisted officials that reside over them. And I couldn't agree with you more. You also on that same article, I believe you put up there where they could actually contact the governor. You've got his email address, his phone number. Maybe we could put that up, Rob, and show people that as well. And I encourage everybody to do the same. You don't have to be from Connecticut to voice your opinion on this. Obviously, don't do any, threats or, use bad language or anything, but definitely express your opinion. And maybe we should pray for the guy. I know that sounds silly, but obviously he has made a deal with the devil. And, Alex Jones has always said that if the devil would ever own a company, it would be Monsanto. And, I don't know, this guy, how he could look at himself in the mirror each night after doing something like this. Overwhelming a majority of people in Connecticut did not, they wanted this thing to go through, and yet he shut it down.
Yeah, Darren, I'll tell you what, and the reason that I wrote it like I did as far as local, state, and federal government is you've got everything from these governors that are trying to twist and take out parts of bills and work with Monsanto right on up to President Obama, who said he was going to want to label GM. That was one of his promises, was to label GMO foods. And what's one of the first things he does? He nominates Michael Taylor, who's a former vice president of Monsanto, to be in charge of food safety, for God's sake. It's just ridiculous, the ownership that Monsanto has with the government.
Well, nobody should be too surprised about all that. I think we could see that coming a mile away. But, I want to switch gears right now. Let's go switch gears and talk about medical tyranny, which you're an expert in. And you're one of the leading experts in vaccine damage. Unfortunately, you learned the hard way. I understand your youngest son was vaccinated and got hurt by a vaccination. Could you briefly tell us what happened with your son, but I actually, and elaborate on that. Tell us how you were able to reverse much of the adverse effects from the vaccinations as well.
Well, my son was vaccine injured at 20 months of age. A lot of people know the story already. Walking, talking, beautiful blue-eyed baby boy, walk him into the pediatrician's office, gets his vaccines, high fever. Next thing you know, constant crying, constant diarrhea for 4.5 years, totally ill, failure to thrive. And we finally realized what it was long after the statute of limitations, which, would you believe it or not, are involved with vaccine injury as well. And we just met up with the right people, particularly at Autism One, which is a big conference that's held actually the weekend after this weekend in Chicago. And our first conference there, we met a lot of other people, a lot of doctors that said there's hope. And we started listening to these doctors and these nutritionists and started working with homeopaths and naturopaths. And our son is now 65% recovered, and he's getting better every day.
Well, that is certainly some good news. And what do you think about reports that we're getting that doctors are actually firing their patients for parents who refuse to vaccine their children? The doctors are firing their patients. Have you heard about that? And what do you think about that?
Yeah. Well, what's ludicrous about that is, how in the heck is it that I pay you for services and you can fire me? No, I fire you. When I'm the one paying the bills, I'm the one that fires you.
That's what I say. Two could play at that game. If you have a doctor that's going to insist on injecting, your family with poisonous vaccinations, you could fire them. And more doctors are starting to lean our way, and the more doctors that we fire, these other doctors will start to emerge in the process. Hey, look, I got an article I wanted to share with you, and I understand you might know a little bit about this. I just learned about this recently. California Assembly Bill focuses on skipped vaccines, and it says that parents would have to take a trip to the doctor's office before opting out of vaccines to their children. Parents who choose to send unvaccinated children to school must present a signed waiver from a physician stating that they have been informed about the benefits and risk of immunizations, blah, 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 and the public health consequences of opting out. Oh, my God. What do you think about that?
Well, this article is really misleading. And the primary reason why it's misleading is because they're making it sound like you go to your doctor to get a medical exemption. What they're not telling you here is it's not the medical exemption that we're talking about. Now, they don't have in California a philosophical or religious exemption. They've kind of morphed it into one. Call it a PBE or a personal belief exemption.
That's
okay.
Right, that's right.
And so basically what they're trying to do is say, if you have a personal belief as a parent that your child should not be vaccinated, somehow an allopathic physician has to validate your personal beliefs or your religious or philosophical beliefs. That is just an affront to personal freedom. It's disgusting to me.
Well, how about a bill that says that, that you should, parents should read the dangers of vaccinations before they consent to giving their kids one? And that would make more sense.
Well, and we actually have that bill here in Missouri, where I'm from. Yeah, I'm from the home state of Monsanto. In fact, I'm about an hour and 15 minutes north of them. And we actually have a congressman here that tried to get that bill put in, and it didn't make it to session. I'm talking with him now, and he's going to try to put it into the next session. But yeah, we actually have a politician here in Missouri that wanted to make that mandatory for children up to 7 years of age, and it didn't get anywhere. But yet this bill that says a doctor has to tell you whether they can validate your personal or religious beliefs, that's just sailing through everything. It's gone through the Health Committee, it's been through the House now, and now it's going into the Senate Health Committee, which means it's not very far away from the governor's desk.
Well, that's pretty scary. The article continues. It says public health officials have been battling a growing belief among some parents that there is a link between vaccines and autism, a perception that persists even after researchers say one of the most publicized studies supporting the link was debunked. Your comments?
Yeah, well, Dr. Wakefield is who they're referring to there, and I personally know him. And he's a great guy.
And he's been on our show several times, by the way. You probably know that as well.
Absolutely. He's been on my show as well. And I'm going to tell you what's amazing is they tell the people that it's been debunked because the powers that be and the pharmaceutical industry has told them it's been debunked. Meanwhile, over 25 different studies have replicated his findings. How is that debunked? It's absolute propaganda. It's total lies, which makes these people criminals.
And it's junk science.
It's pseudoscience, there's no doubt, but yet we're the conspiracy theorists.
That's right. Well, speaking of conspiracy theorist, there is a... Now, you sent us this one. This is from Jezebel.com. Yeah. It's a celebrity, sex, fashion for women type of website. But the... I read this, and I... Oh, my God. I was so angry after reading this. The title is called Getting Measles Trendy Among Babies Whose Asshole Parents Didn't Vaccinate Them. And let me just read a little bit of this. Are you a baby? Did your parents make the jerky decision not to vaccinate you? Well, then, you are in for some fevery, itchy, rash-tastic fun because measles are back. Thanks to modern medicine and mass immunization, by the year 2000, measles was considered all but eliminated from the U.S. But then along came Jenny McCarthy's tinfoil hat theories that vaccines caused autism and dick parents who assumed that other kids' immunity would protect their kids and the vaccines were government mind-controlled drugs. Where did you find this and did you try to contact her? Tell us about this article.
Oh, yeah. I tried to contact Erin Gloria Ryan and I even tried to post on her story. I tried to tell her the truth and tell people what a jerk she was and what a you know what she was the way from the title of the article, and she wouldn't even post the comment on her article. If you notice on the post, they're all positive. She's going through all the negative articles, which I told all my listeners to contact as well. None of the posts have been posted on this article.
You know, I tried to post something myself and it was rejected.
So, oh yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
And I'll tell you what I love about that is what she doesn't seem to understand, and this is a moron that obviously is just a knee-jerk reaction herself. She doesn't know anything about the topic she's writing about, because if she had, she would have looked at the Morbidity and Mortality Weekly report from the year before the measles vaccine was brought out that said measles were already 85%. Measles fatalities were eradicated 85% before the vaccine ever came out. But that never gets into any of these stories, whether it's mainstream media or some idiot like on Jezebel.
Well, and doctors are being trained, and they're told to sell the vaccines. But now people are starting to become more and more aware of the dangers, thanks to people like you. And, I always feel that, you know, when something bad happens to me, a lot of times it's a blessing in disguise. And I think, you know, we could look at what happened with your son. You know, obviously, that was a very traumatic experience. But look what good came from it. Through that trauma and through that experience, you're able to investigate, learn all that you have up to this point about the dangers of vaccinations. You're educating everyone else. And you and your son, you guys are actually stopping and preventing other parents from making the same mistake. You're also helping reverse the side effects that may have already taken place. So I commend you for what you're doing. We're almost out of time, but briefly, I want you to go over in closing what your next, you know, what's next on your agenda. Tell us a little bit about your radio show on the Natural News Network and what's next for Kurt Linderman Sr.
Well, I'll tell you, my radio show is on during Alex's show, so that's kind of a bummer, but you can catch the archives, naturalnewsradio.com. The name of the show is Linderman Unleashed, and it is hardcore, in your face. I don't hold back any punches. I was a MMA fighter for a number of years before my knees got bad, and I do radio the same way I fought in the ring. I'm ready to go at them, and my wife and I and some partners of us are just about this next weekend at Autism One Conference. We're going to launch a brand new company called Box Organics, which is going to distribute organic food by mail order through about 2/3 of the nation, and we're looking to get bigger. It's going to be huge.
Sign me
up. We're just pushing this stuff, and we're going to get people healthy, and we're going to do it despite the United States government.
That's right. All of us work together, and you know, count me in on that. I'll definitely sign up for that. Well, Kurt Linderman Sr., thank you for joining us. You know, I've always said that we need 100,000 Paul Revere's right now. You are definitely one of them. It's good to have you on our side. And, you know, I can't wait for your next article and look forward to having you back on the show sometime in the very near future. Thank you.
Thank you, man.
All right, folks, and that just about does it for tonight's show. Be sure to join us tomorrow night. We have a very special broadcast. Sibel Edmonds will be live video Skype in an interview with Alex Jones. That's FBI translator and 9/11 whistleblower Sibel Edmonds tomorrow night on the InfoWars Nightly News. Be sure to tune in. Until then, good night, God bless, and fight the new world order.
Well, you gotta ask me, have as a nation, have we become that dumb? I'm sorry to use that word, saying as a nation we are becoming dumb and desensitized, that they can actually spread it in front of us, put it there, and we don't react any longer. As I said, if we can go every day, millions of us, and get fundled and stop reacting, they can get away. They're saying now we're gonna hide it in our body cavities. I told my husband, I said, I can't do
this. No, they're going to grab you with cops, here. And when your kids cry, that's going to be bad, and they're going to billy club you. Now they have the police with them, and take your kids in there. I mean, and look, then you say don't fly. They're now on the highways and bus stations. I mean, it is so incredible. It is incredible. It's actually happening. I mean, we are jumping in the fire of Hades here very, very, very quick. Sibel Edmonds is our guest. She'll be back in an in-depth interview with graphics and documents tomorrow on the Nightly News. We'll give you her websites when we come back from break. Classifiedwoman.com is one of them. Give us the Boiling Frogs website. Just give it to us right now.
It's BoilingFrogsPose.com.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is so disgusting.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure. And it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. 100%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
This year, about one in every 50 U.S. homes will have a break-in. That's almost one per block. Will that one home be yours? Well, I found an amazing little gadget to keep the bad guys fooled, and it's called Fake TV. Fake TV is a low-cost, small electronic security device that makes it look like someone is home watching TV. When you go on summer vacation, yes, get rid of the obvious signs you're away by stopping the mail and the paper, but go a step further in fooling crooks with Fake TV. At only $34.95, what? That can't be right. Yes, for only $34.95, Fake TV could be the difference between coming home to a secure house or one that's been ransacked and all your possessions gone. Fake TV simulates the light from a real TV and can be programmed just like a lamp on a timer. Use Fake TV in any room for just $34.95 and get additional Fake TVs for only $29.95. Go to faketv.com or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV, 877-5-FAKE-TV, or go to faketv.com. For safety, security, and peace of mind, use Fake TV.
There are so many benefits you can get from taking unheated whey protein. It helps put out the fire of inflammation and the pain it is causing. Eliminate the craving for carbohydrates, better sense of well-being, weight loss, muscle strength, energy, and growth, and optimal glutathione production. Glutathione is the number one means by which you detoxify all toxins, and this is vital to you feeling and looking good again. Consuming One World Whey is the most powerful way to raise glutathione. People report the elimination of pain and bloating after 1 month, as well as an improvement in strength, energy, and blood sugar. Children love the flavor and prefer it over junk food. One World Whey is performing mighty miracles for young and old. It is superior, unique, and unprecedented from any other whey protein powder on the market. Call 888-988-3325. Mention coupon code KNOCKOUT and you'll receive a free tube of KNOCKOUT pain cream with your order, which eliminates soft tissue pain in 10 minutes for 90% of users. Call 888-988-3325 or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
I hear the train coming. It's rolling around the bend. And I ain't seen the sunshine since. I don't know when.
I'm stuck in TSA prison and time keeps dragging on.
By the way, during the break, I was looking at articles. I see these all the time around the country. These new checkpoints they're setting up, they do a lot of them in Tennessee because they see that as an enemy population that may revolt. At these new TSA checkpoints, they have the local police rob your wallet. And as little as $500 is seen as illegal. There's no law, but they say, no judge, no jury. You can't prove. One case in Texas with the state police years ago, the woman had been at the bank. It was like $4,000. She even had the receipt that it was. They said, it's gone, lady. And if you argue, they go ahead and just take your car and impound it, too, and say, well, this must be drugs. In fact, show folks that article. We're going to be posting it on Infowars.com. That's News Channel 5. Man loses $22,000 in new policing for profit case. And it just goes through. The police pull you over. But that's a case of $22,000. And they say they're keeping it. If somebody told me this could happen to them, I absolutely would not believe it could happen in America. Buddy, you're not in America. You're in Bankistan now, okay? And the police defend it. They just say, look, doesn't matter if you got receipts. Doesn't matter if you are buying, you know, a bunch of trees for cash like a guy in Texas. Doesn't matter. Just, we're taking it. Asset forfeiture seizure. Shut up! Excuse me. Okay, and they're going to ship narcotics in, too. That's just the way it is. Sibel Edmonds, we got about 3 or 4 minutes left. I hope folks will get your book. You're risking your life over this. I've even seen him prosecute journalists that talk to whistleblowers, so maybe I'll get in trouble by the narcotics trafficking, murdering government that's using our money against us.
We may be laughing right now, but I won't be surprised because how things have been escalating nonstop. And by getting this book, by reading it, by letting other people know, people will be standing up for the freedom of speech, for the First Amendment. And also, it is raising awareness because so many people, and I tested this, I gave it to people who were not activists. They really, you know, they are the ones who tune into the mainstream media and watch Dancing Under the Stars or whatever is that show. I don't even have TV in my house. And they read it. Oh, I had I am just shocked because to me it just reads like fiction.
Ma'am, all over the country now, the police pull you over and in some cases take as little as $500. And I mean from old ladies. They're not even taking it from like gangbangers. It's bad enough. I mean, this country is burning down right now.
So, yes, please, for the listeners, get this book, read it, and become active. Put the word out and say, as long as we take it, they are going to escalate it. There's only one solution, and that is for us to stand up for our own rights. And I tell whistleblowers, don't go to Congress anymore. There is one way, and that is the real revolution, to bring about revolution. Don't write petition to Congress. I was dumb enough to do that and waste time for years, even when you and I talked last time, Alex, 4 or 5 years ago. I believed that if I got 100,000 people petitioning the Congress, something was going to happen. Today, I tell them, don't waste your time.
You got a few good people up there, but the rest of them...
That's right.
Are involved in the drug trafficking. They're criminals. I'm sorry,
yes,
go ahead.
Well, because they are. And that's one of the things the book gets into. Of the dozens of congressional people exposed in this criminal ring, they're in the pocket of foreign lobby and the heroin dealers, especially the ones in Chicago. Well, out of those people, six, seven of them are still in there. So when people, they read this, they're like, this is what we are dealing with. And this only dealt with Turkey. Imagine with all the other ones, how many more criminals are in there in Congress? They are not answerable to you, the person, the citizen. They are answerable to their bosses. Those millions of dollars given to them by various interests, military-industrial complex, oil, you have the banking industry.
And here's the deal.
Yes.
The military-industrial complex, it doesn't just want to kill a bunch of foreigners now, which is bad enough. They want to destroy America and literally destroy the free market and take over, and we've got to stop them. Unbelievable. Sibel Edmonds, we'll talk to you again tomorrow night on the Nightly News, PrisonPlanet.tv.
Thank you very, very much,
Thank
Alex.
You. Thank you. PrisonPlanet.tv.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com
Big Nightly
today.
News tomorrow night, by the way, folks. Oh, boy.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee.
Attack, but it also has built up my natural immune defenses against colds and flus. Extendivite has so many benefits that we all should be taking Extendivite to build up our defenses for what superbugs might emerge yet. So start today, clean out the toxins, and be as healthy as you can be. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Wow, I tuned in to the big local morning talk show, and I thought it was Alex Jones on the air. So I called in, and they put me right on air, and they just basically totally agreed with me and told me I'd been right all these years. And that happens with so many radio shows that would criticize us in the past, because people now see that what we've warned of is unfolding. Foreign interests have hijacked the federal government, and they are using our tax money against us to turn the United States, and the same thing's being done in every other industrialized country, into a classical, hardcore, in-your-face tyranny. And what's really waking people up is the announcement of 30,000 drones in the next decade to be phased in, and watching national news like Fox News, where they're, that's right, Is that potting soil explosives? Homeland Security is going to be watching you and looking through your windows and checking out everything you do. Drones are in the sky. The Pentagon is watching you to keep you safe. It's like a science fiction movie you'd see in the 80s of the future police state of a dystopia. And it's our money. There's potholes everywhere. There's hundreds of heads being chopped off and left on the border every week. There's total bedlam going on, all sorts of crime exploding. The system will do nothing about that. We have 7+ million people in the prison system, double communist China, who has 1.3 billion people. We're 310 million. And their answer is home inspectors under new enviro regs where you go to jail if your weather stripping isn't right. The green police. You know, you saw those green police ads with Audi 3 years ago, and they had admitted that, oh, this is actually what's planned. That's even the green police uniforms the feds and locals are wearing. It's a white shirt with little green epaulets and green pants, and it's here. And Infowars.com has the Mike Adams report from naturalnews.com. L.A. County health enforcers conduct door-to-door raw milk confiscation operations. And I went and looked it up. It's actually happening. They went and got the customer list of people buying from big mainline dairies. I mean, in Los Angeles, if you're at any movie star's house, and I've been to quite a few, it's raw milk right there in the refrigerator because they are into quality. Well, and the general public's getting into it. Well, not anymore. They are getting the customer list and coming without warrants and intimidating their way into the houses. Now, you have to understand, there's mass murder and death going on just a few miles south of the border there every day. Total corruption, crack whores everywhere like zombies walking around, people's daughters traveling to L.A. thinking they're going to be movie stars, being fed into the prostitution meat grinder, troops committing suicide en masse, record numbers, collapse of society happening all over the place, and they've got code enforcers, that's what they're calling them, from the health department, demanding that you give us that jug of milk. Ladies and gentlemen, in fact, I didn't think to do this. Will you please? Well, I'll do it after the break. I'll just get a jug of it. We've got like 3 gallons always that I keep here in the office, and I had a big old glass of it with whey that I got from InfoWarsTeam.com, by the way. Best whey's up there, in my humble opinion. And I had an evil whey shake yesterday instead of lunch, and it was awesome. And you know what? I had the Austin police chief in here. See, he hadn't gotten the new download of tyranny yet. And I said, here, I got some raw milk. Here, have a drink. And he drank it. He goes, oh, that's good. Oh, in California, pal, you're a hardcore criminal, Art Aceveda, drinking milk. SWAT teams are now hitting people growing different plants like, what's the one you use for burns? Aloe vera, that's evil. It's all evil. It's all evil, but the evil, it's good.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond Gusset Jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond Gusset Jeans got it. Others don't.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
The Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
FBI translator who, on the day of 9/11, the day before 9/11, heard the CIA commanding Al-Qaeda